online right now, if you're wondering why I'm checking on you guys, I would like to say thank you for watching me. And yeah, yesterday I posted that I wasn't ready to pray with you guys, but we prayed even though I also went to church and I prayed for you guys. Even though I wasn't live, always know that I'm always praying for PMP Ministry friends and members, and you are loved by God. God is you got God's favor, and God's presence is always there to help you and provide anything that you want. Hallelujah, Jesus. God hands almighty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Rabbi. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you, Jesus. I'm just waiting for everybody to come live. I'm going to put my phone down so we can pray and bring this fire. Hallelujah. God is. Let's praise him every time. We are waiting for people to come and tune in live. While we are waiting, we should be praising him. We should thank God for what he has done for us. We should thank God for his favor. Hallelujah, Jesus. I thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Manifesting your Hallelujah.
destiny. Your God ordained the purpose of living. That means, let me explain the meaning of ordained. Hallelujah. Ordained is someone, priest or minister, meaning that he has given you a purpose. He has given you an intelligence. He has given you power. He has given you pretty much a creativity mind to be out there, to be a soul winner, to be a lover, to create your own businesses, to create your own life, to have your own money, not to be a loser. The Bible says that he has given you a star. It says, I've sent the light that you will not be worried, because you're going to be glowing. Even in the dark, you're going to be glowing. Hallelujah, Jesus, thank you for your light. Thank you for your star, Lord. Thank you, Father, for giving me a star. Thank you, Father, because I'm a different kind of person in my own way. Thank you, Father, for blessing my sisters, whoever they are watching, and my brothers. Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah. So it says that for example, I'll give you an example. Some people have issues. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, help me. Father, Lord, connect with me so that everything that I speak is not about me, Jesus. It's only about you, God. May you, Father, Lord, speak through me. Make me a vessel, Jesus. Lord, I'm ready, Father. Hallelujah. It says that you have the star. God has opened the door for you. Let me tell you one thing. Your star can be hold on. That the devil can be trying to hold it. He can try to close your star. He can try to close. It's like when there's a light and you put a cover on top of the light. You can let the light get dark a little bit because it's covered. So the devil can try to come and destroy you and try to destroy your destiny so that you don't have to shine. But I want to tell you one thing. He says every child of God has a star. That every child of God has a purpose, and your destiny is your star. And if you just know your purpose, that your destiny is going to overshine it. And when it's overshining the world, you will never lack anything. Hallelujah. Did you ever hear the saying that when you do what you love and you start making money on what you love, because you love that thing so much, you don't feel like you're working? It's like your destiny. God will never give you something is no good. Remember, the Bible says the devil is here to destroy, but God is here to tell you that if you just give me your hope, if you just believe in me, you don't need no competition. You don't need to hate on your friend. You don't need to hate on your brother. You don't need to hate on your sister. All you need is to believe in him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The prayer points we are going to be engaging, hallelujah, today shall be focusing on destroying the power of the kingdom of darkness fighting against our destiny. The power of the kingdom of darkness fighting against our destiny. Let me tell you one thing. I'll give you two different of type. That you have a business. You have a business mind, and you have tried the business for years and years. It doesn't go anywhere. Or for example, you've been singing gospel for a long time. You've been praying. You've been trying. Like for example, my life. I'll tell you my life example. When I was going to LA, I was there for almost 9 years. I worked and worked and worked and worked. But the devil was trying to destroy me so I don't have to connect with my destiny. Because the devil knows that I am good at this. I am good at working for God. The devil knows that I'm very good on praying. So what he did was to delay me. He covered my star. He gave me another purpose so that I can be blind to not see my purpose. And let me tell you one thing. You have distraction. You have problems. You have trial. But God will still protect you, because no matter what you go through, God will protect you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is so good. Thank you, Jesus, for being kind, Jesus. So he says that no matter what enemy is trying to destroy you, I'll give you an example. Like there's a story of a mother who has a daughter, who had a son-in-law. My mother had a son-in-law, and that son that married his daughter, that daughter didn't know that the husband was a criminal. Neither does the mother knew. But the mother was so was with the son, and then somehow the son saw that he just stole money and he wanted to give it to the mother-in-law. When they gave it to the mother-in-law for trying for the protection so they can pass by, and the police came to the house, and then they came to the house to look for that criminal.
But because the daughter and the mother was in association with the criminal, they all end up being in jail. So you have to be careful with what is your association. You have to be careful of what you are going through, because surrounding you, your surrounding can also put you in dim, on the dim. You can find yourself in hell. You can find yourself in trouble. You can find yourself in problems because your surrounding can keep you in that situation. And that's the situation. The mother was so innocent. She was just sitting there trying to love the son-in-law. But she didn't know that the son-in-law was a criminal. But when the FBI and the police came, they didn't care who is there. They would take everybody and every evidence, and they'll find the result later. But what they do is to take you. So you have to pray against that. You have to say, God, I destroy every darkness. It says that I destroy every focusing destroyer that is trying to overtake in my life and fighting against my destiny. Because that mother has her own destiny. But because of that, the son-in-law is a criminal. She ended up being in a part of that criminal stuff. Because she was living innocent. So even the people that you are associating with you, the people that you are listening around, the people that have been around you, they can affect you, and you can find yourself into doom that you never wanted to be in. So today is the day we're going to pray. It says, those who are secretly plotting against you to see that all your affects paralyzed. You know what the meaning of paralyzed? Meaning all your affect, all your labor, all your work that you've been doing to be paralyzed. Let me tell you one thing. I am not perfect, but I know that God is using me as his vessel. Because I'm a human being, I have trials. I have temptation. Those that can be those things that they want to paralyze you. They'll find a way to paralyze you. They'll find a way to affect you so that you can be a paralyzed. It says that today we're going to pray to destroy every secret plotting against you, to see that your affects to be paralyzed. Meaning that, let me explain the affect, because so many people may take an example of affect in a different way. Affect, I wrote it down. It says affect, it says make an affect to achieve or complete task. That God has put in you, God has given you a task in this world. He has given you a task to accomplish. And that task is your destiny. That task is your job, your business. But the devil will be around here to destroy, to hold you back from your task, so that it can make sure that it's paralyzed. When the task is paralyzed, meaning that you can have business for years and years, you won't move forward because it's been paralyzed. And then it also says that it's like climbing the mountain. That some people have climbed the mountain, they're all the way up there. Their life has the business and their life has grown. But you, since you've been climbing the mountain for 12, 15, 20 years, and nothing is going on, you are not getting no result. So what he's saying right now, we have to destroy every plotting against you that is making you to be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Lord, we destroy every plotting against my life. Pray, say, Lord, I destroy by the power that you have given me. I destroy every plotting against my life that is trying to destroy my affect, that is trying to destroy my labor. Lord, I destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. I will reach where I'm going. I will be on the top. I will not stop now. Whatever is trying to plot, whatever is trying to destroy me, in the mighty name of Jesus, as you gain, hallelujah, as you gain this prayer point today, God will expose them and give you a supernatural victory. I'm telling you, how is before supernatural victory? It's when that mother who was so he was trusting the brother-in-law, I mean the son-in-law, and he went to jail. That's when the police do the checkup and cleanup, and they find out that the mother was innocent. That's why they get to release. Normally in America, when they put you in jail, they have to find the evidence. They have to make sure that they prove you guilty. So when they did not prove her guilty, God sent the supernatural. God sent the supernatural victory. That's when you see the light coming down upon you. And God said, do not be worried, because I'm opening up the way. I am giving you light, and I'm going to be your path. That's what he's saying. He says that God, he will expose them, and he will give you a supernatural power. He will give you a supernatural victory to find every demonic that is trying to be against you, that is trying to destroy you. He said, God is a powerful, hallelujah. He says, God, empower us to destroy every barrier standing. standard between you and your fulfillment. Hallelujah. This is a very good one. The devil is here to destroy. The devil is here to destroy. The devil is here to put a barrier. This is a barrier. Let me tell you, people of God, you don't want this to be the devil. Let this book, for example, to be God. Because if this is God, then when the devil is coming to hit you, he hit God, then he goes back. But if this is the devil, then you are in trouble. That means you can't move forward. Because the Bible says that I am before you. Do not be worried. I will not leave you because I will never forsake you. But if the Satan is the one before you, then you are in trouble. So we have to destroy every barrier standing between you and your fulfillment. Every barrier standing between you and your fulfillment of your destiny. Father Lord, we destroy every barrier that is standing between me and my fulfillment, between me and my destiny. Father Lord, I scatter, I destroy it, I break it, I excel it. In the name of Jesus, it exit. I exit it. In the mighty name of Jesus, every barrier that is trying to destroy me so that I don't get to fulfill my destiny, that's why I don't got to get it. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I take that victory. I take the supernatural victory that you are giving me, oh Lord. I destroy every barrier, everything, every supernatural evil that is trying to destroy me. I destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy it in the name of Jesus. Every barrier that is standing between me and my fulfillment destiny, I destroy in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's read the book of Matthew 17:20. This is my favorite. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It said, because you have so little faith, truly I tell you, if you have as small as mustard seed, you can say to the mountain, move from there to here, and the mountain will move there. Hallelujah. And it says that it will move from there. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It says, move from here to there, and it will move there. It also says that there will be nothing that will hold you back, and everything will not be impossible. Everything will be possible. God is saying that if you have faith, hallelujah. God is saying that if you have faith, if you have faith in God, it says that in Matthew 17:20, because you have a little faith, if you have as small as a mustard seed, you can tell the mountain to move. You can tell the river to separate, just like Moses, and it shall be done. And nothing will be impossible. Say that I'm possible. I destroy every darkness of impossibility in the name of Jesus. I'm possible in the name of Jesus. He says nothing will be impossible. Everything that you want, every day, there's always a first time for somebody. Just like my spiritual father was saying, that if you want something, if you are eager to get something, just proclaim it. Be the first one to say, Lord, you have given me a star, you have given me a destiny, and you have given me a purpose. I proclaim and declare that I'm taking this on my own, and I don't care if nobody has done it before. I will break the record. I will be the first one. Hallelujah. Always be the leader, not the follower. Always be the leader, not the follower. Because God is good. And I'm not saying that you cannot follow. And because a good leader is the one that he follows first before he become a leader. A good leader is the one that has self-control. A good leader that has wisdom. So we need to do this. And I'm not saying that you're perfect. I'm not saying that you have to be perfect. But the Bible says that faith comes by hearing and learning the word of God. So whatever you are trying to get, you can continue trying. You can continue trying. Continue fasting, just like the way we are fasting, just like Daniel refused to eat the food in the kingdom of Bethlehem. He just wanted to have wisdom. He wanted to have get closer. He was hungry. He was humble, and he was ready. And that's why you were. You're a good leader, is a humble leader. I am trying to learn that, because sometimes when you want to eat so much, because I used to love to eat a lot, sometimes I lose control. Sometimes I'm a human being, but what you have to do is to keep on fighting, because when you're fighting and God sees your heart, God sees your He says that the God sent us our Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit is our intercessor. The Holy Spirit knows our mental. He knows our physical. He knows our emotional. So that when you're going through that, God can actually balance it. Because the Holy Spirit is here to be your helper. Thank you, Jesus. So we have to pray. He says that everything will not be impossible. Nothing will never be impossible. tell us that he's telling us the Bible of Matthew, the book of Matthew 17:20, is telling us that we have an authority to destroy every power of the devil that is trying to destroy us. So let's pray. Let every step, hallelujah, God, let every step of the enemy, every step of the enemy that is trying to destroy my progress, it's time to take a lead on my progress. I destroy the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is a good prayer point. Follow and read after me. Pray after me, because this is going to free you. Let me tell you one thing. The more you pray every day, the more God is going to free you. The more God is going to give you your purpose. The more God is going to give you a start. And I'm not saying that you don't actually, you have a start. The start is there, but the Satan is putting a barrier. And that's why we destroy the barrier. Every spirit of barrier that is standing against my future, my fulfillment, against my destiny, I destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. Our first one, it says, let each step the enemy of my progress take lead them so that they can have a greater distraction. It says that every step of the enemy that is trying to take and step and trying to destroy you in your progress, let it be a distraction, a greater distraction. Father, Lord, we send a big distraction in my enemy in the name of Jesus. Whatever they are trying to plan, whatever they are trying to distract, whatever assignment they are trying to assign, I send a distraction. May they be lost. May they be lost just like the way. Hallelujah, Father. Thank you, Jesus. May they be blind. May they be lost. Every enemy that is trying to lead any assignment, any progression in the plan that is trying to destroy, I destroy it. I send a destruction. Destruction in the witchcraft camp. In the mighty name of Jesus, I send a destruction in their camp. In a manner never. In the name of Jesus, whatever the step the enemy is taking against my life, they should find themselves nowhere. Whatever the step the enemy is trying to take against your life, may they be found from nowhere. May they find themselves in the desert. May they be lost. May they not find you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh Lord, we thank you, Jesus. The next one, it says, any witchcraft, any demonic chain binding my hands and my feet from prospering, I break and scatter it and shatter it to the pieces in the name of Jesus. Any demonic, hallelujah, this is so crazy. Any demonic, because last time we talked about the handcuffs, you know, demonic is like the one that is standing between your barrier. And sometimes they may not stand in your barrier. They may come in so that they can hold you. They can handcuff you. And then they also put the cuffs on your legs so that you don't have to move. And every time you move, you fail. Anytime you move, you fail. And that's when you get so tired. You get so lazy. You are not able to move forward because you have handcuffs and you have cups in your head that is always, you are locked up. So here we're going to destroy that. This is a straw player. He says that every demonic chains binding my hands and my feet from progressing, I break it and shatter it into pieces. I shatter it into pieces. I break every demonic that is trying to handcuff me, that is trying to break me, and is trying to close me and chain me, chain my leg, chain my hands, so that I cannot be progressing. I break it. I break it. I shatter it into pieces in the name of Jesus. I shatter it into pieces. Another prayer says, I break with the blood of Jesus all evil so tight affecting my life. All evil so tight that they're so tight, you know, like every time when unfinished business, unfinished deliverance, when you are praying and praying and praying, there's always one thing that is addiction, one problem, or one demonic that was trying to follow you that did not go. It says that every unfinished business and every unfinished chance, any unfinished, a little foundation of chance that you destroyed somebody past in the future and they're trying to destroy you back, you are a child of God now. You are blessed. So we have to destroy every demonic, every Jesus. I break with the blood of Jesus all the evil soul tied affecting my life. In the name of Jesus, I break with the blood of Jesus all the evil soul tied that is trying to destroy me, affecting my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah. Any door that I have opened to the demonic, to witchcraft in any area of my life, be closed forever by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, any door that I've opened by mistake, any door that I've opened by knowingly, any enemies that I've created during my life, I destroy it, I close it, and I throw it away by the blood of Jesus. I clean it out in the name of Jesus. When I'm praying like this, repeat out of me and destroy it in the mighty name of Jesus. This is the last prayer. It's very strong. Put it together and remember, I'm going to explain it to you because it's very important. It says, I retrieve my integrity from the hands of the household of demonic, from the hands of the household of the witchcraft. It says, I retrieve, hallelujah. I retrieve my integrity, hallelujah. It says, I retrieve my integrity from the hands of the household of witchcraft. Meaning, what is the meaning of integrity? It means that the quality, hallelujah, the quality of being honest, your quality of being honest, your identity, your integrity, something that you have. The devil always want to put the shame and fear and humiliation in your life. That's when you're losing your integrity. The quality of honest and having a strong moral principle. When people have no strong moral principle, that's when they go to be a prostitute, because they are not afraid of showing their body everywhere, sleeping around and destroying their life. People who smoke or killing or all the things that in 10 commandments that Jesus said, or that God says you should not do, you are losing your integrity. The devil is taking your moral principle, he's taking all the things, the uprightness. You know, you have to be a righteousness, but when the devil takes your integrity, he takes everything. That means you are becoming like a naked person, like you have no integrity, you have no honest, you are always lying. And if they know you pass around, all they know is that you are a liar. I destroy, I retrieve, I take back my life in the name of Jesus. I take back my right, my integrity in the name of Jesus. I take back my identity in the mighty name of Jesus. I retrieve my integrity from the hands of the witchcraft in the mighty name of Jesus. I retrieve my integrity from the hands of the witchcraft in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for the Bible. I thank you, Father, because John 1 and 5 says, he says, the light shine in the darkness. And it says, the light shine in the darkness. And the darkness has not overpowered it. That the light will shine in the darkness. And the darkness will be weak. The darkness will not overpower the light. Lord, I thank you, Father, for giving me the light. Lord, I thank you, Father, for giving PMP ministry members the light. Father, Lord, I thank for everybody that is watching, for giving them a light. Father, Lord, I thank you, Jesus. And it feels for your very first time to be connected with Christ, that you want to be restored in your life, that you want to be born again, that you want to be connected. You just want to reconnect with your God. You just want to have that connection and friendship. Pray after me. Lord, dear God. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. Come into my life. Come into my life, Jesus. Forgive me, Lord, for all my sins. From now on, Father, Lord, I receive you as my Lord and Savior. Father, help me to live accordingly and use my body as your vessel in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you for everybody that is watching behind this screen. Lord, I thank you for everybody that is connecting with me. Father, Lord, I thank you for the surrounding. I thank you for the PMP ministry. We are growing healthy and good. Lord, I thank you, Father, because I'm here to say that you are blessing me and you are making me learn with them together. Father, Lord, as I grow and they are growing, Lord, we thank you, Father, for always teaching us. Lord, we thank you, Father, because it's not always about me, it's about about you, Jesus. Lord, thank you for using me, my body, and my as a vessel. Lord, I appreciate you, God. I thank you, Father. Don't forget to share and share and share. Don't forget it to share to your friend. It may not, this message may not be about you, but it may be about somebody else. It may not be for you, but it may be somebody else. Somebody may be connected. Don't forget to share and follow on Instagram, also on Twitter, on YouTube, and Facebook, PMP Ministry. Thank you for watching Preach and Praise Ministry. I love you guys, and may God bless you. And do not forget, you are your kind of beautiful. You are your own star. Never forget.